We have already seen that differentiability of u and v is not enough to guarantee differentiability of f. In this video, we will learn that we will need more of u and v. They also need to satisfy the so-called Cauchy-Riemann equations. In this video, we will learn what those equations are and why they need to be satisfied. So, we write our f of z as u plus I times v, and we write our point z0 as x0 plus I times y0, and now we say, suppose f prime in z0 exists. We suppose f is differentiable at z0. Can we express f prime of z0 in terms of the partial derivatives of u and v? And does this imply something for the partial derivatives of u and v? Well, first of all, we'll set delta z equals delta x plus I times delta y. Now we can express delta w in terms of u and v. Delta w equals f in z0 plus delta z minus f z0. And if you express this in terms of u and v, x0, delta x, y0, and delta y, you get a big mess. But okay. Here we have our f of z0 plus delta z equals u plus I times v. And u has to be evaluated at x0 plus delta x, y0 plus delta y. And v also has to be evaluated at x0 plus delta x and y0 plus delta y. And then you have minus f of z0, that's just u plus I times v, now evaluated at x0 comma y0 for both u and v. Then we can write our delta w over delta z as follows, divide by delta x plus I times delta y for your delta z, and we take separately the real parts and the imaginary parts, so the u and the v over here. The u at x0 plus delta x, comma y0 plus delta y, minus u at x0 comma y0 as real part, and similarly for the imaginary part. Well, how does this help us? Well, f is differentiable, so this if you take the limit delta z to 0, this limit has to exist, and we can take this limit in many ways, but we will take it in two different ways. First, we go along the real axis to 0. So that means that we put delta y to 0 first, and then we take the limit delta x to 0. Well, if we take delta y to 0, that means that the delta y's over here and over here, over here and over here, they are all 0. So then limit delta z to 0 of delta w over delta z becomes delta x to 0, and the we are left with those expressions over here. But you recognize those. Those are just the partial derivatives of u with respect to x and v with respect to x. So what you get is ux in the point x0, y0 plus I times vx in the point x0, y0. But that's just one limit. We went along the real axis. So what happens if we go, for example, along the imaginary axis? So what happens if we set delta x to 0, and then we take delta y in the limit to 0. So now we set those delta x's over here, over here, over here, and over here all to 0, and we take delta y to 0. Then we get something which looks a bit different, but if you look carefully, and here you immediately recognize vy in x0, y0, and if you look carefully here, you recognize 1 over I times uy in the point x0, y0, so minus I times uy, x0, y0. Well, we assumed that this limit exists, which means that we need these expressions here to be equal. So that means that if f is differentiable, then ux has to be equal to vy, real parts have to be equal, and vx has to be equal to minus uy. That's what certainly needs to be satisfied if f is differentiable at z0. And that's the theorem. If f prime exists at z0, then you need ux equals vy and uy equals minus vx. And those are called Cauchy-Riemann equations. Now, and if f is differentiable, you can find this derivative here in terms of u and v, then f prime at z0 is just ux plus I times vx at this point. Here you see that If f is differentiable, you certainly can't have all u and v. You certainly need that the Cauchy-Riemann equations are satisfied. This is a necessary condition, which means that for your u, you have ux equals vy, and uy equals minus vx.